we are reading from Bhagavad Gita as it is, Gita Bhushan commentaries, chapter number 3, text number 35. Is the sound okay on Zoom? I hope the sound is okay. Okay, so now we're going to discuss text number 35. श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
पराधर्मो भयावह
पराधर्मो भयावह
श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
पराधर्मो भयावह
पराधर्मो भयावह
श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
पराधर्मो भयावह
पराधर्मो भयावह
श्रेयान्
स्वधर्मो विगुणः
श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
परधर्मो भयावह
परधर्मो भयावह Somebody wants? श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः
पराधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
पराधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात्
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
स्वधर्मे निधनं श्रेयः
परधर्मो भयावह
पराधर्मो भयावह Okay, let us read the word meanings. श्रेयान्
श्रेयः
far
better
swadharmaha
swadharmaha
once
prescribed duties
vigunaha
vigunaha
even faulty
even faulty
paradharma
paradharma
then duties mentioned for others
then duties mentioned for others
swanushthita
swanushthita
perfectly done
perfectly done
swadharme
swadharme
in one's prescribed duties
in one's prescribed duties
nidhanam
nidhanam
निधनन हाँ निधनम
निधनम
डिस्ट्रक्शन
डिस्ट्रक्शन
श्रेय
श्रेय
बेटर
बेटर
परधर्म
परधर्म
ड्यूटीज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड फॉर अदर्स
ड्यूटीज प्रिस्क्राइब्ड फॉर अदर्स
भयावह
भयावह
डेंजरस
डेंजरस
ट्रांसलेशन It is far better to discharge one's prescribed duties even though faultily than another's duties perfectly. Destruction in the course of performing one's own duty is better than engaging in another's duties for to follow another's path is dangerous. Let us read see the Sanskrit. Shreyan swadharmo vigunaha. Shreyan means better. Swadharma means following your own duties. Vigunaha, even if it is not being done properly, it is better. Paradharmat swa anushthitat. But doing somebody else dharma very nicely, it is better than, it's not better for a person. Again, I'll try to explain this. Swadharma vigunaha paradharmat swanushtitat shreya. Shreya swadharma viguna. Even if a person does his own duties with faults, that is better than doing others' duties paradharma very nicely. Swadharme nidhanam shreya. Even while doing one's activity, even if a person dies, that is better for him. Paradharmo bhayavaha. But if a person tries to do someone else's duty, kshatriya trying to do the duty of a brahmana, that is bhayavaha. Avaha, if I understand correctly, it means brings, to bring. Bhayavaha. It brings fear in someone's life. So one should understand, it's extremely important that one should understand what is his duty and do it. Instead of trying to imitate others whose subhava and nature is different and that a different duty is prescribed to that person. Okay, we'll discuss it. It's a very important shloka. Let us read the Gita Bhushan commentary. If Arjuna says, you have said that we should give up the proclivities of desire and hatred arising from our natures, common to animals, and engage in dharma, You don't have some read? Oh, yeah. Everybody has to, first when I'm reading, you should read what I'm reading. Look at your book or whatever, smartphone or whatever. Because it's very little complicated. You have to read it. And then this tendency should disappear with purification of the heart through following the duties of dharma. Dharmas of both fighting and non-violence are stated in the scriptures. Because I cannot perform fighting devoid of desire and hatred, the dharma of non-violence with subsistence by gathering surplus grains is superior to fighting for me. It's a very long link. So the Lord has told in the previous shloka, Raga Desha, Raga attachment, Raga Desha Vyavasthitaho. Indriyasya indriyasya arthe raga desho vyavasthitau tayor navasham agachet tauhi asya paripanthino. We have discussed that yesterday. That the senses have natural tendency for attachment and hatred towards their sense objects. So now Arjuna will say that, yes, you have said this. So we should not come in control of raga and desh. You have just now said, is it not? Very, very nicely said. You just now told, last shloka you told, that one should not come under the control of attachment and aversion. You only told. And that attachment and aversion is controlled by following dharma. Okay, this is clear? Okay. Otherwise, you know, a person is animalistic. He just does what he feels like doing, does not feel like doing. That is animalistic propensity. So then Arjuna's argument is, this tendency of raga and dvesh get purified by dharma. I 100% accept it. But then there are two kinds of dharmas. One is the dharma of a kshatriya, which is full of violence. And another is a dharma of a brahmana, completely peaceful and non-violent. But you see, my dear Krishna, I cannot do this dharma of kshatriya without attachment and aversion. So that's why it's not proper me to fight. Quite interesting how a conditioned soul finds some excuse to... Arjuna is not a conditioned soul. But just this shows our situation, how we find some excuse to not do our duty. Just like one devotee told, I just read the message. Hold on, you will really laugh on this. Dandavat Pranam Prabhuji, when we suffer from fever, cold and cough, then hearing and chanting is not so perfect. So is it beneficial as in normal case? Nama Pratu nahi. So hidden this question is, maybe it's better that I don't do hearing and chanting when I am having fever. Something always we find some, although this is a sincere devotee, is asking a genuine question, but our mind tricks us. देखो बुखार है जब तो ठीक से कर नहीं पाओगे जब करो ही मत ऐसे आर्ग्यूमेंट दे सकता है कोई सो एनीहाउ द पॉइंट इज अर्जुन इज सेइंग इफ आई फाइट आई मस्ट हेट सम पीपल इज इट नॉट इफ आई डोंट हेट एनीवन हाउ आई एम गोइंग टू फाइट एंड इफ आई डोंट हैव अ डिजायर टू कॉन्कर दिस If I don't have a desire to gain victory and gain kingdom, how will I fight? So it's better for me. Because I am not able to do this dharma of kshatriya without attachment and aversion, it is very nice for me to do other dharma, which is non-violence, which is the dharma of a brahmana. And in that way, I'll become free from attachment and aversion. So that is the argument of Arjuna, but let's see, Krishna does not approve that. Whatever dharma is prescribed by the Vedas in terms of varna and ashram performed incompletely, lacking some elements. Vigunha means it's not that a person is not able to do full duty, but something is not able to do, is better than executing a different dharma, paradharmat, even though it is executed completely with all parts. So anushtitat. Anushthan, you understand? Understand to do something. As su anushthan means to do something very nicely. So I think the meaning of these words are clear to you. Okay. For instance, the natural dharma of the brahmana is non-violence and that of the kshatriya is fighting. One should not execute dharma beyond the sanction of the Vedas. Jitna bola ja raha hai utna karo. डू एज यू आर टोल्ड टू डू, डोंट डू धर्म विच इज बियॉन्ड योर कैपेसिटी और बियॉन्ड योर नेचर ऑल्सो. डूइंग सो इज लाइक परफॉर्मिंग द फंक्शंस ऑफ द आई विद अ डिफरेंट ऑर्गन. क्वाइट एन अमेजिंग एग्जाम्पल. कैन वी सी बाय आवर हैंड? कैन वी ईट बाय आवर आईज? Well, partially, yes. If the food is being cooked and simply like looking, it's called darshane ardh bhojan. While looking at it, you can eat half. That's why the cooks don't like to eat. It's my own experience. When I used to cook khichdi and offer to the Lord, I did not feel the same taste as somebody else cooks the khichdi and then you take prasadam. Have you experienced, Anand Prabhu? Last time was when you had cooked something? 5-6 years back. So he's forgotten. But this is actually naturally a fact. Because you smell it and you see it, there is no, how to say it, excitement when you look at it. You have already experienced it. Yadapati Prabhu knows, he is a good cook, so he knows it. Is it not Yadapati Prabhu? Used to, I think last lockdown, he cooked very nice things for devotees. So it may not, for the cook, it may not simple anything. Anyhow, we are just drifting the point. The point is, we cannot eat with our eyes, we cannot see with our hands. So similarly, a Kshatriya must do his duty as a Kshatriya, a Brahmana has to do his duty as a Brahmana. But I know you will have some objections about Vishwamitra and others. So we'll discuss those points also. Jaimini says, Chodana Lakshana Dharmana, Dharma. Dharma is characterized by rules. There's something very nice I learned from it. Why? It reminds me of the shloka, very famous shloka. What is that? Paradharma? सवै पुंसाम परो धर्मो यतो भक्तिर अधोक्षजे अहेतुकी अप्रतिहता येनात्मा सुप्रसिद्धि. I was just reflecting upon it that dharma means characterized by rules. Rules have to be followed. So those rules are highest transcendental rules by which a person develops bhakti, selfless, nishkam bhakti towards the Supreme Lord Krishna. And just this point which came to me. And we have so many rules, is it not? Get up for Mangalarti, take bath and get up for Mangalarti. One devotee was not showing his video on the Zoom. I said, why? He said, I'm in Paniyan. So I said, my dear Prabhu, you are selling kurtas, is it not? So why? How can you say you don't have a kurta? It's just laziness, is it not? Since I am in home, I am not going to temple, I can just be in Paniyan, whatever Paniyan is called. I don't know, Paniyan is called Paniyan. I don't know what it's called in English. West, whatever, and then I not put a kurta or not have a proper dress, but it's not like that. Even if a person is a grahastha or in a sitting in his home, still he should be doing Mangalarti, and Mangalarti you don't do in Baniyan. There are rules and regulations. You cannot do Mangalarti in gown, that doesn't work, or jeans pant. The rules are there so that we become conscious, I am doing an arati to Krishna, which will ultimately lead to a pure devotional service. All those rules and regulations are there. I just saying something on dharma. So one should be very eager to do this kind of dharma, that means Bhagavad dharma. The reason why it is better is then stated, that means following one's own dharma is better than other is stated here. It is better to die nidhanam in the execution of one's own dharma. This produces the best results because there is no loss or sin in acting imperfectly, and because in the next life one will be able to execute that dharma properly. I think this is very, very clear. When a person is doing activity which is prescribed by Vedas as per his nature, swabhav, then there is no sin. Hear very carefully. Whenever there is fire, there is smoke. This example will be given by the Lord in, I believe, 18th chapter. Where is that example? Dhumen. No. In Bhagavad Gita, wherever there is Agni, there is fire, there is some smoke also. I'm forgetting the shloka, but that is there in the 18th chapter, if I'm not wrong. So wherever there is fire, there is some smoke. But it doesn't mean that you can't use fire for some purpose. Or it doesn't mean that fire is impure. Okay? Similarly, any activity you do in this world will be contaminated by some fault. But if a person does what is as per his adhikar, what is prescribed by the Vedas for him, that is very good for him. Make sense? And that will lead, even if he dies doing that, that will lead to his purification, number one. And because of that purification, his next life, he will be able to do that dharma very nicely. So the point is, as a Kshatriya, even if you are not fully free from rag and dvesh, but it is better for you to do your duty as a Kshatriya. And then later on you will be promoted to do your duties without raga and dvesha. That's my understanding of it. But trying to do your duty of a Brahmana does not actually immediately make you free from attachment and aversion. Basically, in my practical understanding of it is, some works which we like to do, which are not sinful, obviously, then we should be trained, a person should be trained to use that capacity to serve Krishna. Bhagavat Paritoshanam. Can you search the shloka 1.5.37? Very nicely that is been explained there. Let me search on my own laptop. Very nice. Actions which are offered to the Lord, as per our nature, they can be, we can do certain things which can be done as an offering to the Lord. No. They're not 37, it was 37 probably. Where's the shloka gone? Yeah, 35, sorry. Yadatra kriyate karma bhagavat paritoshanam jnanam yattad adhinam hi bhakti yoga samanvitam. Whatever work is done here in this life for the satisfaction of the mission of the Lord is called bhakti yoga or transcendental loving service to the Lord, and what is called knowledge becomes a concomitant factor. 1.5.35. So people can be engaged as per their capacity, as per their natural attachment to doing certain things, and they can be engaged in the mission of the Lord, and that becomes bhakti yoga. Make sense? But trying to do something artificial will not be possible. I just give a very simple example. If I ask any of the Vaishnavas here to become devotee kitchen in charge, how many of you are ready? Nobody is ready except R. Prabhu. He knows manage. Maybe he can do that. It's just impossible, is it not? One devotee said, I can remember shlokas, but I cannot give class. The philosophical points just don't come in my consciousness. Make sense? And you see in our temple, so many Matajis are there who have been making flower garlands for Krishna for over 25 or 30 years, daily, every day, 30 years. Make sense? So we have to understand that everybody is different as per his different swabhav, and then he has to engage in that. He has to be engaged in that capacity, not try to do something else or someone else's duty also. Okay, I think it's very clear. Performing a different dharma causes misfortune for the person, bhayavah, by creating sins, since it is prohibited in the scriptures. So, samajh mein aa raha hai? Vedas don't say that a Kshatriya should become a Brahmana. No, he has to behave as a Kshatriya. We will hear this in the commentaries. A Kshatriya who dies in the battlefield, he gains the same destination as a sannyasi when he leaves the body. We have discussed this. We'll not discuss this, but we'll be discussing it in the coming shlokas. Now, objection is of Parashuram and Vishwamitra, which is discussed here. In the case of Parashuram and Vishwamitra, however, there is no deviation from scriptures. Though born in Brahmana, Parashuram, and Kshatriya, Vishwamitra families respectively, they performed activities according to their particular great qualities. Okay. Even then, they were criticized and fell into problems. Also, Drona and other Brahmanas practicing Kshatriya Dharma were also criticized many times. First of all, let us reflect something upon Parashuramji. So Parashuramji was born as a Brahmana. He was born as a Brahmana, son of Jamadagni. But he behaved as a Kshatriya and he killed so many Kshatriyas. But we must understand, because he is an avatar of the Supreme Lord, he is not actually bound by the rules and regulations prescribed by the Vedas. Still, he was criticized. Second, Vishwamitra. He also wanted to become a Brahmana and did lot of austerities. But there is a famous problem, you know that. Menaka first happened. Then he fell down to lust. And then what happened next? Who came next? Somebody came next. Again somebody came next. I'm not remembering the name of the Apsara. Rambha, I'm not sure. Rambha. Maybe Rambha came. Then he became angry. So then also it was a fault. Am I correct? Vishwamitra two times had trouble or only one time? Two times. Now first was lust and then second was anger. Then further he keep on doing austerities. Then he could actually come over these things. It's not easy, is it? No? So he was also criticized. But obviously because of special austerities, they could transcend their nature. And Dronacharya also was criticized. Being a Brahmana, he sided with the wrong party. Party which is on the part of sin. When he was criticized, he was specially criticized for not speaking against the attempted dishonor of Mother Draupadi. You remember that Drona and Bhishma, they were all criticized for that. Now Arjuna will argue, or Arjuna can put his argument. I have heard that Devarati means Jarak Maharaj, and other Kshatriyas renounce the world. Therefore, why is non-violence considered the wrong dharma for me? We have also heard of Bharat Maharaj in young age renouncing the kingdom. So Arjuna also must be knowing about it, is it not? It's not that only we are reading Bhagavatam. So they have renounced the world. What is the difficulty if I renounce the world and I accept non-violence? Note, Devarati is another name of King Janaka. In old age he renounced, not in young age. Generally, however, the Kshatriyas take Vanaprastha rather than Sannyas. So, you got the argument of Arjuna, if others can do, why we can't do? That's what we say, is it not? Are bhai, wo bhi to sura hai Mangalarti. He is also sleeping in Mangalarti. He is not doing any service. My dear in charge, why are you not saying anything to him? And that's how, that's a natural way of finding some excuse of not doing our duties. We always find our superiors. Superiors, ideals. He to nahi ja raha hai, mujhe bhi nahi jana chahiye. By performing one's prescribed duty in the previous ashram, one decreases desire until one is qualified for renunciation. The person can then practice non-violence because it then becomes his prescribed dharma. Thus, it is suitable that one who is situated in his own dharma can later do this. Are you able to understand this? Arjuna is young. Quite young, not old at all. And he has a lot of energy in his body. And if he does not utilize it for Krishna's seva, and he thinks that just becoming non-violent and running into the forest will help, it will not help. Many times the devotees explain this. Later on, if somebody, suppose Arjuna would have renounced the war, and he would have ran to the forest, and somebody would have challenged him, hey, kya kahenge usko? Kayar, coward, you ran from the battle. Again, he would have raised the sword or whatever, his bow and arrows. A very simple point in this case, you can understand. You know, when Arjuna was a little bit drifted away in the battle of Kurukshetra, then Yudhishthira Maharaj was attacked by Karna. And then he was severely wounded and he came back to the camp and he was waiting for Arjuna. He was thinking that Arjuna will kill Karna. Do you know this pastime? It's a very famous pastime. And then when he came, Arjuna, when he heard that Yudhishthira Maharaj was wounded, he came back and he asked for Yudhishthira Maharaj's welfare. Are you all well, right? All right, my dear brother. Then he said, did you kill Karna? I must assume that you must have killed Karna. That's why you're coming to me in such a happy mood and like that. Then Arjuna said, no, I have not killed Karna. Then he said, you must immediately give up this Gandiv. You are useless. So Arjuna immediately took out his sword. He said, I had taken a vow that anybody who will tell me that you give up this Gandiv, I'll kill him. In that pastime, you don't know. So you see, he can't give up his nature. His own brother, whom he loved so much, more than his life. Kshatriya ka swabhav hi hota hai. And then Arjuna say, kya kar rahe ho bhai? What are you doing? Are you going to kill your elder brother? So he said, don't kill him, just offend him by words. Offending a superior by words is as good as killing him. So then Arjuna said some wrong words to Yudhishthira Maharaj. Then he said he wanted to kill himself. He said, how can I live after saying such bad words to my superiors? Then Krishna said, no, you don't have to kill yourself. Just glorify yourself. That is as good as killing oneself. That is quite amazing instruction by Krishna, is it not? And we tend to kill ourselves every day, is it not? How good I am, how whatever. So, and suppose somebody says something good about you. Kya kaha aapne? What did you say? Immediately. It's like, is there, you know, if somebody has cooked something, said, this is very nice. Can I say? Kya cha? Again, they want to hear that. But I just told a story. So that you see the Sabhava Kshatriya is like this. Or you also see how Bhishma Pitama fought with his own spiritual master, what is his name? Parashuramji. So this is the nature of Kshatriya. Again, one more example. You see when Karna, on Karna's lap, Parashuramji was sleeping. And there was a scorpion or something, some insect, which is biting through his flesh. He could tolerate it. So that his guru's sleep will not get disturbed. I'm giving the example how Kshatriyas are. They will behave the way they behave. And then when Parshuram wakes up, he says, so much blood in your hand. He said, this is all happened. He said, you cannot be a Brahmana. You are a cheater. A Brahmana cannot tolerate this much of suffering. You are a Kshatriya. So, because I am not a Kshatriya, I don't know. Maybe you may claim to be Kshatriya, but none of you are Kshatriyas. It's very difficult. It's very difficult. But how a Kshatriya actually feels is very difficult for us to understand. Same, Dhruva Maharaj. Maharaj said, bachcha ho, you are bachcha, you are small boy. What you are seeing that I have been offended. No. Then he said, if you can show me the way to see Krishna or Vishnu, show me, otherwise you get out of my way. He was so determined. And actually Naraji appreciates. And Naraji there also gives him this advice. You be peaceful. I'll go to your father and we'll mend everything nice. Nah. So we are learning here that to be situated in one's own dharma is much better. I give an example. Some people are very in spiritual life also. Some people just have, because of their previous advancement, can chant whole day, can read Bhagavatam whole day, and this is very good. But if I try to imitate, very difficult. I give a very simple example by which you'll understand. Practical real life example. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sarasvati Thakurji had two disciples. But many disciples, I'm giving case study of two disciples. One disciple's name was His Holiness Akinchan Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, who from his previous life's impressions had so much natural taste for chanting. Whole day he will chant. And then a complaint went to Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakurji. He does not do anything except chanting. Then he asked, and he takes prasadam two times. So he said, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakurji asked him that, does he do prajalpa? No, he doesn't do prajalpa. Just chant Hare Krishna. Okay. Another brahmachari I won't name. He said, kya? We have to serve for 8 hours, 10 hours, and he only chants Hare Krishna. This is not fair. So then Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakurji said, oh, you want to chant Hare Krishna? Okay, from tomorrow your only service to chant Hare Krishna and take 2 times prasadam. So first day he chanted for 12 hours, next day he chanted for 12 hours, and third or fourth day he could not do it. He said, no, I cannot. So you see, if you try, chanting Hare Krishna is very good. But if you don't have a natural taste for it, we can't do it for all day. So we have to be engaged in different ways by which our energy can be engaged in Krishna service. Otherwise, we'll become very much disturbed. I think now you must be understanding. Purport. One should therefore discharge his prescribed duties in full Krishna consciousness rather than those prescribed for others. One thing which is very important, which Prabhupada is mentioning, is Krishna consciousness. Yes, I am a total servant of Krishna, but this is my nature, Swabhav, and I must engage my Swabhav in Krishna's service. This is very important for us. Not simply to engage our Swabhav, but to engage our Swabhav in Krishna's service. Just like particularly if I talk about my own Swabhav, I am not a shy person. Just sit down, or not even a Bhajanandi, we just sit down and it's just not my Swabhav. Wherever I get something good, I want to share it to others. For some days in my life, I try to be like somebody else who just may be inward and antarmukhi and all those things. It didn't work for me. It doesn't work. So now I have stopped to I've stopped this plan forever. I will never hold myself back. At least that's my sankalpa. Whatever swabhava is there, just engage in Krishna service. And that works very nice. At least I'm talking about myself, works nice, very nice for me. So I'm seeing in among our devotees, somebody's a designer, somebody's website, can make a website, somebody's into whatever translation work we can do. Every head has different services. And I always pray to Krishna that somehow they give me the intelligence to help people to engage in their swabhava. There was one devotee who was always giving me trouble by asking my stupid questions. I cannot tell what stupid questions they were asking, but they're asking. Then I gave them transcription seva. You keep on transcribing one service, doing one lectures. Now no more wrong questions. Because they like to do this transcription. Then hearing Harikatha and transcription, hearing Harikatha and transcription. And now he's very happy. So that's the nature, is it not? One time when Mataji asked to Ramakant Prabhu, she invited him for prasadam, said, Ramakant Prabhu asked that Mataji, you made such a nice prasadam. How are you able to make such wonderful prasadam? Then Mataji asked, how are you able to give such nice katha? All of us are differently empowered by the Lord. So don't hold that energy. Give it, you use it in Krishna's service. You should use it in Krishna's mission. Then you will be very happy. Make sense? One disciple of Srila Prabhupada came to Prabhupada for initiation, maybe after initiation, just at the time of initiation, asked, what can I do for you, Prabhupada? Then Prabhupada asked, what do you want to do for Krishna? Make sense? This is a very nice point. So everybody should, in consultation with Vaishnava, seeing his own nature, see what is his nature, and then use it for Krishna's service. Okay? And nobody is high and low in that. Everybody is doing his service to Krishna. Materially, prescribed duties are duties enjoined according to one's psychophysical condition under the spell of the modes of material nature. Have you understood this line? We are all under the spell of modes of material nature, different combinations. So everybody will be differently, everybody will be differently illusioned, so to speak. Kuch samajh rahe hain kya keh raha hu? Everybody's swabhava will be different. For some people to just do this morning program day after day is so nice. And for some it's a punishment. Are koi to break hona chahiye na? There has to be some break someday, is it not? Sunday at least, is it not? Something. Or I see like our Parth Krishna Prabhu so much eager for traveling. He likes to. He will find some excuse for traveling. And I'll find some excuse for not traveling. For me, traveling is a big austerity, you know, disturb my schedule, my sadhana, my reading and all that. He could stay very happy in Kumbh Mela. I was miserable in Kumbh Mela. Everywhere there is shouting, everywhere there is sound, and when I'm going to study, when I'm going to, you know, all do my regular things. So nobody is high and low, everybody is different, that's what. I give an example, I think I've given earlier also. You have seen Krishna's garlands, very beautiful garlands. Then in garlands, is there only one flower? No, there are many flowers, but there's a common thread by which they are weaved together and offered to Krishna. So in this way, all of us are different, but seeing our swabhav, we should engage in Krishna service. Like many times I push people, why don't you preach? I mean, I will keep on doing that. I'm not going to stop. But for some people to just to preach is very difficult. But for them to assist in preaching is very easy. They can cook prasadam, they can do other things. It's just difficult. For them to distribute books is very easy. But to lead and guide devotees is very difficult. Doesn't mean that they are lesser devotees. Please try to understand. Just it is not their swabhav. I'm learning it quite well in that way. And that way able to see all the Vaishnavas are different and they have different desires and inclinations by which they want to serve Krishna. So much the main thing we should see is that their devotee want to serve Krishna in a particular way. Spiritual duties are as ordered by the spiritual master for the transcendental service of Krishna, and they will also be different as per the disciples or the person's nature. But whether material or spiritual, one should stick to his prescribed duties even up to death rather than imitate another's prescribed duties. I tell you a story. during Srila Prabhupada's personal presence here, one disciple went to Mayapur and he wanted to chant it 140 rounds per day. And he chanted also some days and then he lost. Finished. Bloop. So we are not saying you don't chant 140 rounds per day, but is it your adhikar to do that? That you must question. Then we become unsettled and then he left. That is not, aisa nahi hota hai. Bhakti, we have to do whole life, life after life. Do what you can do. Duties on the spiritual platform and duties on the material platform may be different, but the principle of following the authorized direction is always good for the performer. And what is the difficulty in doing it? Because as condition shows, the highest austerity for us is to listen to someone superior. Because who can be superior than me? Mattaha paratram nanyat kinchit asti dhananjaya. There is no one superior to me. That is what the conditioned soul thinks. But this shlokla applies only to Krishna, not to conditioned soul. Well, you can say there can be no one more fallen than me. That we can say. We cannot say there is no one superior to me. When one is under the spell of the modes of material nature, one should follow the prescribed rules for his particular situation and should not imitate others. It's very easy to understand. For example, a Brahmana who is in the mode of goodness is non-violent, whereas a Kshatriya who is in the mode of passion is allowed to be violent. As such, for a Kshatriya, it is better to be vanquished following the rules of violence than to imitate a Brahmana who follows the principles of non-violence. I think this is very easy to understand. We have discussed these things. Everyone has to cleanse his heart by a gradual process, not abruptly. Now, this is very good. You see, there are some devotees who just don't want to get married. This is from their previous lives. And there are some devotees who just want to get married. In spite of hearing all the difficulties and pains of grihastha life, no, not pains, I will use a heavy word, horrors of grihastha life, still they have to get married, no matter what you preach to them. This is not my words, I heard it from His Holiness Radha Govind Maharaj. Somebody's Babaji, so Babaji means Virakt, natural from his previous life, if you tell him to become a grihastha, he will be miserable. And some, it's actually a fact, it's a real life thing. One of my students was forcibly married, and he actually, before his marriage, he left and joined one ISKCON temple. He was detached, forcibly married, and he ran away. Now he cannot be found. He must be in some ISKCON temple. But that was the mistake of the father or parents to actually force the boy who has this tendency to not get married into marriage. And we know also that there was one Brahmachari who joined under me. He said, Prabhuji, you please be my Siksha Guru. And for my highest welfare, you please give me guidance. Okay, fine. And then he was doing sound system seva. And you know, sound system seva means what? Just like you come here, what is the difficulty switching on the sound system? Not very heavy system, heavy seva. Prabhuji, mera sar dard kar raha hai. My such a difficult service, my head is cracking and this. What is so difficult in switching on the sound system? You know, that's not very complicated. But later on, I understood he wanted to get married. And now after getting married, he's very much enthusiastically doing all the services, 8 hours, 9 hours. So I'm not just making fun of him. He was trying to be a brahmachari, although he was not a brahmachari. So this better is that he becomes a grihastha. I'm not saying becoming grihastha is better. For him it is better and practice Krishna consciousness. You remember what Vrindavanchand Maharaji, His Holiness Vrindavanchand Maharaj mentioned? Vanam gato yad hari maashrayeta. So a very, very, very important point he kind of emphasized or highlighted was the best thing is to take shelter of Lord Hari. Some people leave their homes and drink charas. Marijuana, that is not good. But best is to leave home and take shelter of Lord Hari. But if a person cannot do and he just leaves home to drink charas or marijuana, that is not good. Billions of times that is much better is if a person stays home and practice Krishna consciousness under superior guidance. I think this must be very pleasing to hear for many devotees. As per your sanskars, you can do whatever you can like to accept. So it's not that if you speak of Vairagya, then everybody will become Vairagi. He has to, but you test your own heart. Do you really want to experience the horrors of grihastha life? Then you enter. इतना हैवी नहीं होना चाहता था बट इफ अ पर्सन रियली वॉन्ट्स टू एक्सपीरियंस देन ओके यू कैन बाय द टिकट एंड वॉच द मूवी हिमसेल्फ बट इट वोंट बी ओवर इन 3 hours बट देर आर सम पीपल हु जस्ट रिमेन वेरी आई जस्ट आर जोकिंग बट देर आर सम पीपल हु कैन डू दैट can practice Krishna consciousness in the grihastha life and they feel comfortable there. And there are some people who want to be in ashram and do that. So you find yourself where you are situated, where your heart speaks, aapka hriday kahan jata hai, where your heart speaks and you choose that ashram and do that. But main thing is chanting of 16 rounds is not to be neglected. I was just chastising yesterday one grihastha devotee. Prabhuji, aapka night duty hai kya? Do you have night duty that you are not able coming at 6 a.m. or 6:30? No, Prabhuji, no night duty. For night duty, a person is able to, ready to, whatever, for some, what I say, paper, currency is paper, for some paper, he is ready to do all night shift. But for pleasing Krishna, he is not ready to wake up at even 4 a.m. So that cannot be compromised. Grihe thako, vane thako, sada hari bole dako. So I'm saying if a person wants to be with wife and children, that's fine. But they should also all be engaged in Krishna service. ठीक है ना? भोग करके भोगने का लाइसेंस नहीं दिया जा रहा है, सोने का लाइसेंस नहीं दिया जा रहा है. However, when one transcends the modes of material nature and is fully situated in Krishna consciousness, he can perform anything and everything under the direction of a bona fide spiritual master. So now, the Prabhupada is referring to Parashuramji. In that complete stage of Krishna consciousness, the Kshatriya may act as a Brahmana or a Brahmana may act as a Kshatriya. In the transcendental stage, the distinctions of the material world do not apply. For example, Vishwamitra was originally a Kshatriya, but later on he acted as a Brahmana, whereas Parashuram was a Brahmana, but later on he acted as a Kshatriya. Being transcendentally situated, they could do so, but as long as one is on the material platform, he must perform his duties according to the modes of material nature. At the same time, he must have a full sense of Krishna consciousness. So the whole picture is, if a person is transcendental to modes of material nature, he can do any activity. I mean, any activity under the guidance of the spiritual master, that's not a problem. But as long as we are under the modes of material nature, we must behave as per the duties as prescribed by Shastra and the spiritual master. A case in point comes in my heart is Naradji. Naradji kept Kayadru in his ashram and gave her instructions. Hari, brahmachari, okay, Mataji ko instruction de raha hai. Being a brahmachari, he is giving instruction to a Mataji. But you must remember that can only be done by Naradji. We cannot do that. समझ रहे ना मेरी बात? You cannot have a Mataji in the ashram and give her instruction and then say I am brahmachari. It doesn't work. Are you able to understand? You will see in 7th canto. So he is completely transcendental. So he can do that. And also you will see later on in 9th canto, Parashuramji killed so many Kshatriyas, but he was not tainted by sin. Still, to set an example, he did some prayaschitta. I am forgetting that prayaschitta, something like that, and Kurukshetra somewhere. So the crux of the matter is that everybody should try to purify his heart slowly. Or slowly mean to say, heart will not get purified immediately. ऐसा नहीं कि आज हरि नाम करना शुरू करते हो हम आज ही सब कृष्ण भक्त हो जाएंगे, मतलब इन द सेंस शुद्ध भक्त हो जाएंगे. इट विल टेक सम टाइम, सो वी शुड डू आवर ड्यूटीज रेगुलरली. मेन थिंग इज रेगुलेशन इन आवर लाइफ, ब्रिंग रेगुलेशन इन लाइफ, एंड विच एवर आश्रम अ पर्सन इज सिचुएटेड, एक्ट एज पर दैट एंड मेक एडवांसमेंट ग्रेजुअली. आर देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस? ओके. How to identify one's swabhav in today's age? Be under guidance. this is, everybody's swabhav is different. You discuss with the devotees and they were superiors, then they can understand what is one's swabhav. Somebody has having has inclination for business. I'm talking about material aspect. Somebody may be into teaching, somebody like that. But main thing is that even as per, that's like our Shashikant Prabhu is into farming, our Rukmani Vallabh Prabhu is into cooking. So different services a person does. I'm just giving an example from our temple. And our like Natavar Prabhu is into business. So, but it does not mean that 16 rounds is not to be done. That should not be compromised. And then first priority should be there, and then engage yourself in different ways, is it not? One thing very simple you can understand, like if suppose a person is Brahminical and you tell him to be a manager, it is just impossible for him. Certain thing which is against your swabhav, you just cannot do. That, this is a point, what is it, process of exclusion. This I cannot do. From that you can also understand. And what are the things we can easily do? I'm talking in terms of what you have to do for your professional purposes. Kuch cheeze aap kar hi nahi sakte. To woh to unko to bahar hi kar dena chahiye. You must remove them from your, how to say, list. Ye mera swabhav hai. And then be in the association of devotees, ask them, then you can do that. It is so practical that Krishna asks us to accept Swadharma and not our Kula Dharma. Many families feel we should compulsorily continue the occupation of the previous generations. It's a very good point. I have known a devotee who is actually a Brahmana. Actually, what is his name? Sharma or some Pandey? Sharma, I think it was Sharma. And his father is a Vaishya. And his father is forcing him to be a Vaishya. I said, Aray Baba, you are a Brahmana by caste. And his proclivity or inclination is also to preach the message of Mahaprabhu. So why you want to be a Vaishya? It will not work for you. And it's not working for him. He's unka man nahi lagta. His heart is not into business. He cannot do business. I'm forgetting the surname. I know the names. If my swabhav is kshatriya, why I imitate duty of a brahmana? So we should not imitate the duty of a brahmana. Why should you imitate the duty of a brahmana? Elimination process. Okay. So we stop here.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Prabhuji, in 18th chapter, they mentioned that Sardharman Pratajamamekam Sardambhaji. Krishna is saying that you surrender all dharmas to me, whatever dharma you are. Then another way, way the Prabhupada also said that we want that everyone should be calm in platform of Brahman.
Brahmana, yes.
So how can we understand this, that here if we left our dharma, then there will be not good.
First thing Prabhupada is asking that Krishna instructs in Bhagavad Gita, Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. So, first of all, it means is don't take shelter of your varnashram dharma, that it will deliver you. You take shelter of me. But he still asked Arjuna to fight for Krishna. So it's a very important point. Taking shelter of Krishna means serving Krishna, is it not? And still Arjuna fought as a Kshatriya and in that way served Krishna. Still Krishna did not leave him, said you become a Brahmana. This you follow? And the second part is, everybody should come to the platform of Brahmana. Should come to the platform of Brahmana. It doesn't mean that everybody will come to the platform of Brahmana in one life itself. Ho jayega, sir? Just like you see, can you ask your father immediately to give Bhagavad Gita class? Why? You should behave like a Brahmana. Speak in the mic. Give the answer. Why can't you ask your father to give Bhagavad Gita class immediately? Is he not a devotee? Ask. He is a devotee, very good devotee. Does he not want to serve Krishna? Want to serve Krishna. Is he not doing service to Krishna nicely? He does it very nicely. But why is he not being asked by you to give Bhagavad Gita class? Speak in the mic. What is answer?
It's a different nature to serve.
Yes, simple. Even if you want everyone to give Bhagavad Gita class, we need so many preachers, but it is not possible for most devotees to speak on Bhagavad Gita. वो बोली नहीं पाएंगे. वो समझ जाए यही बहुत बड़ी बात. they can, if they can understand, that also is very good. To speak is very difficult. I have seen so many times. One devotee was saying, Prabhuji, why were you saying yesterday that are you understanding? And then he spoke something and I said, that's why I was saying, are you understanding? Because he did not understand what I was speaking. Is nothing no wrong? At least you are hearing, is it not? Sun to pad raha hai, kuch to pad raha hai. Krishna gives some people some ability and Krishna does not give it. Anyhow, everybody can chant Hare Krishna. Everybody can be a small flower in the garland which is being offered to Krishna. So that's what I'm trying to say. Really, you see, you cannot make your father a Brahmana immediately. But if you keep on chanting Hare Krishna, he wants to hear Harikatha, is it not? That's very good. Swabhav nahi jata hai. It is not that easy to give up swabhav. It is not so easy to transcend the modes of material nature. But all that swabhav can be engaged in Krishna's service. I mean, I still don't know what is your specialization? Mobile technologies. I've still not found some way. But suppose if there is some way by which your technical know-how it can be used directly in Krishna's service, will it not be very easy for you to do that? Think about it. Or whatever your Oracle developer. Yes. I have still not found any Oracle use for Krishna consciousness. But if that is, will not be very easy for you? Or for most of us doing something? Just like I was an engineer and I'm so happy and blessed that I've been given services in repair and maintenance of a temple, which I have now switched over to Gomata. Oh no, fixing electrical system and water system and this. This was very helpful for me to be engaged all throughout the day. It's very good. I'm telling from my own experience. Now I can sit and discuss Bhagavatam and read commentaries. Agar pehle bol dete, main aaj refer karne ka ye kaam pehle se kyun nahi kar raha tha? Almost how many years have passed? 2008 to 2021. 13 years. 13 saal se kar raha hota to kaafi ho jata na. But 13 years back, I could not understand Bhagavatam. I could not understand those commentaries and all these things. Sab to tha na, aisa to nahi ki main abhi likha hu usko, aisa to tha nahi. So I'm just saying that as per our adhikar and things, as we get purified, we can do certain things and we can't do certain things. So we should, main thing is be engaged in that way. Now if you actually tell me to be engaged in construction, it is actually difficult for me. I was very happy when Prabhuji said, why don't you give up the position of HOD, which I had already unofficially given up because I was not doing anything there, to some other devotee. He said, yes, Prabhuji, immediately take the check. And I'll just do my service in Gomata and then focus on Shastra. Does it make sense? And my friend who's the HOD there, he's also very good in Shastra. I said, why don't you make Tamil, Telugu, whatever language you speak, tutorials in it. But he does not interest, he's not inclined. He only wants to make some services in a temple, construction service. And does it very nicely, is it not? So I'm just saying, the bottom line of this shloka is, identify your swabhav and act as per that. That is very easy. In that way, we can actually conquer over our animalistic propensities very much easily. Otherwise, we try to go against it. वही काम करेंगे जो हमारे स्वभाव है करने का, ठीक है? Okay, so I will do parayan.